I love you, Allah.
So the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasallam, please, I want you to leave this with me. The Prophet walks into the masjid one day, sallallahu alayhi wasallam, yes? Walks into the masjid and finds the Sahaba wrestling. Halal or haram? Would the Sahaba do something haram in the masjid? A'udhu billah, no. So clearly halal, they were wrestling in the masjid. Wrestling, not striking the face, wrestling in the masjid. So he sallallahu alayhi wasallam walks into the masjid and sees the gathering. You know, I just, because I have a very strange way of thinking, let me think out loud with you, and Allahu Alam, I'm not saying this is sharah of the hadith, no, these are just my thoughts. You know, sometimes you're doing something with your friend and it's funny, between you and him it's funny, but then someone walks in and all of a sudden it goes from funny to looking very foolish. Have you ever had that? You know, sometimes someone walks in halfway through the joke and doesn't see the joke, and then you start, oh ya Allah, what a jursa, what an embarrassment. So the Sahaba, this is how I'm thinking, you know. The Sahaba, they're wrestling in the masjid, and then imagine Rasulullah walks in, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Imagine the honor, the izzah of the man. So imagine now the Sahaba, they're wrestling, and now the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam walks in. So you can imagine what happens to the companions. So they all, wow, embarrassing. And then he asks, he says, what are you doing? Please. Didn't the Prophet know what they're doing? He knew exactly what they were doing. But the hadith is not just for them, it's for every Muslim to the day of judgment. And I tell you, Islam is ancient. Habibi, Islam is contempt. Wallah, qasam. Sometimes I will read or hear a hadith or read a verse and it's like Allah said these words in 2019 March. That's how alive the Quran is. People tell me it's old. So he walks in, he sees them wrestling. He says, what are you doing? Ya Rasulullah, marra'a, man, let it go. Khalas, he walked in, we've stopped wrestling, leave it. But because he's the doctor, he's the teacher, and he's there to cure the sicknesses of societies. So they said, Ya Rasulullah, we're wrestling. Then he asks, why are you wrestling? Look at the salt now. Now the salt is straight to the wound. Imagine the Sahaba, Allah, who's going to explain why we're wrestling? Who's going to explain why we're fooling around? So they said, Ya Rasulullah, we're wrestling to see who of us, who amongst us is the... who's the Rijal, brother? Has anything changed in 1400 years? Anything changed? La wallah, it's exactly the same. They're not doing anything haram. Rasulullah knows that they weren't. But he was worried about something far deeper. So what does he say? He said, the Rajal, the man amongst you, is not the one that can physically put down the other. Any meathead can do that. That's not how we determine who the Rajal is. Imagine how the Sahaba felt. Imagine when the Prophet is telling him, this is not how we determine men. He said, the Rajal amongst you, the man amongst you, please, my young brothers, please, don't fall for the fitna of the street, man. This deed will make a man out of you. The street will only make a thug out of you. He said, the Rajal amongst you, the man amongst you is the one who, when a musiba, when a calamity happens, he can control his anger and his wrath. He can control it. He's patient. This is the man.
Thank you.